Did anybody have any fears about the idea of having a foreign device or an implant in your body? I wanted to, I'll just generally open that up to the whole crew.
I did not. I fell off my bicycle when I was 40 years old and broke my hip, and I have 3 pins in my hip. So the quick answer is no, not a problem.
Okay. So you were a seasoned veteran when it comes to implants?
No, that didn't bother me at all either. I think I just wanted to hear better, that it wasn't a problem.
Yeah, easy one for me. My grandma raised me from the time I was born until she passed away when I was 21 in a wheelchair. So seeing my grandma improved her quality of life with a wheelchair, I knew that this, you know, I had no room to complain because I still have my legs. So I'm thinking, well, these implants, if I can hear, then shame on me if I complain.
Mm. Yeah, that's good perspective. So Dr. Thompson, I'll turn to you again. So we hear all kinds of thoughts, fears, and concerns. Do you want to expound upon that? Some of the things that we hear from patients, our prospective audience for this panel?
It is interesting. Patients do come and they do have fears of having a foreign object implanted in their body. I get the simple question of, you know, will I be able to get through the TSA security? To, is there any way that the government or somebody can track me with this? And the system has data logging, but I assure them that it is for sound only and not recording their actual conversations mm-hmm. and things going on along that way. But patients have had difficulties with dental implants or other implants, so then they're always concerned that, you know, this could be a concern with this device. But generally, I send them your direction, and you've waylaid that by educating mm-hmm. them. And so far, we have had zero problems with that. The stigma for so many patients of not being able to hear and feeling like the world is judging them and their intelligence, at times, I think people sometimes overthink that process. And they want to hear better, like Eleanor, but they start finding every little barrier to not jump in full-heartedly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I think that's spot on. We do hear a lot of very widely, very widely spaced concerns, let's put it that way. I do promise that we will address those all, you know, when we see prospective patients. I think each of our panelists can attest to the fact that we really try to sit down and comprehensively answer questions when these come up, because these concerns are valid, and we want to make sure that you feel good about these concerns before you move forward. So at the time of a cochlear implant evaluation visit, we will make dedicated time. And really, I put almost no limit on those visits. I'll just continue to answer questions and alleviate concerns until we're done. And I think that's very important before we move forward on that decision making.